Does your network suffer from periodic unnecessary alarms? Are these alarms distracting your network operators and increasing their workload? In this video, we'll look at how Industrial HiVision can automatically acknowledge intermittent alarms without operator intervention. I'll give you a demonstration of the mechanism in action. Then I'll show you the few simple steps required to activate the auto-acknowledge function. Network management software provides a window into the status and performance of your network. It notifies you of every error or potential error which occurs, allowing you to maintain control. Most networks operate without errors, and changes to the operational status are the exception. But this is not the case for every network. For some networks, especially industrial networks, intermittent failures are a normal occurrence. There are many reasons why recurring problems may happen. For example, some networks may have unreliable wide area connections, which periodically go down. Maybe there is equipment in the field and its power supply occasionally fails. If diagnostic data is downloaded, a bandwidth utilization threshold might be exceeded for a few minutes. In order to deal effectively with these transient alarms, we need to define their characteristics. Firstly, network operators may not want to be notified about these false alarms. After all, nuisance announcements are a distraction. Secondly, the failures are an expected and regular part of normal operation. Thirdly, it's not the failure itself which is interesting, but the duration of the failure. It's important that failures are documented. A simple failure may have masked a more serious problem. As a network administrator, you may need to refer back to failures at a later date. Like other network management software, Industrial HiVision will generate a warning or an error every time a problem occurs. Unlike other network management software, Industrial HiVision includes the possibility to acknowledge these alarms automatically if the fault condition is rectified within a pre-configured period of time, meaning that network operators can devote their full attention to genuine alarms. Let me give you a demonstration of this concept. First, we'll look at standard event handling in Industrial HiVision. Then we'll compare how the same events are handled using automatic acknowledgement. For this demonstration, I'll use the network simulation tool built into Industrial HiVision. This means you can run the same test yourself without requiring any network hardware. The application on the right is the demo network simulation tool. On the left, Industrial HiVision is visualizing the simulated network in real time. For the purpose of this demo, we'll just use the three switches in the ring, plus the Eagle firewall and the EESX embedded switch. Just like a live network, changes to the simulated network will be reflected in Industrial HiVision. First, we will increase the bandwidth utilization between the firewall and the embedded switch. The warning threshold takes effect between 10% and 20% utilization. In Industrial HiVision, the link is now displayed with a status of yellow, and a warning is shown in the event log. we reduce the bandwidth utilization again. The link status becomes green. Green indicates that an alarm condition no longer exists, but the alarm has not been acknowledged by an operator. Next, we'll simulate a failure in the connection between the management station and the network. All five devices are displayed with a status of red, and the errors are shown in the event log. We restore the connection. The devices are displayed in green. There are two points to note. To revert the device status back to normal, the operator must acknowledge the status change. To remove the alarms from the event log, they must also be acknowledged by the operator. Okay, that's how alarms look when Industrial HiVision is in standard mode. The key point is that the operator must take action to acknowledge the events. Now let's look at exactly the same scenario again, but this time the alarms will be acknowledged automatically. The bandwidth utilization is increased. The link status is displayed in yellow, and the alarm is shown in the event log. The bandwidth utilization is decreased. Now spot the difference. The link is displayed in grey, like the other links. The alarm has disappeared from the event log. We disconnect the management station. Like before, the status of the devices is displayed in red and the alarms are shown in the event log. We restore the connection to the network. The status of the devices is back to normal. The event log is empty. So now you've seen the auto-acknowledge function in action. Despite the alarms, the display in Industrial HiVision has returned to normal, like nothing ever occurred, with no intervention from the operator. Perfect for handling non-critical periodic faults. If you would like to see how it's done, keep watching and I'll show you. Please note that this technique uses a function called Event Auto Acknowledge, which was introduced in Industrial HiVision version 8.1. The configuration requires two stages. First, we configure the Event Auto Acknowledge function, then we modify the status colors. The Event Auto-Acknowledge function is located under the Preferences Display menu. Here you can select which events should be acknowledged automatically. These are events which indicate a change of network topology. You must also select the time within which the events must be rectified in order for the event to be acknowledged automatically. Events which exceed this duration will not be acknowledged. The event duration can be configured from seconds to days. Next, we configure the status visualization. We do not require the icon filled background, but we do want the acknowledgement color. Now we modify the status colors. In fact, we just need to change the OK status color to gray. That's it. Let's do a quick test. Perfect. To prove that there really is no operator intervention, we can look at the unacknowledged events. Here you can see that the Industrial HiVision service is acknowledging the events. For completeness, there is one more test we should try. We set the event duration to 2 minutes. So let's see what happens if an alarm situation exists for more than 2 minutes. We cause the alarm scenario again. Now look at the clock in the Industrial HiVision interface. The time is 11:52. I will now fast forward the video. Two and a half minutes have passed. It's now 11:55. Let's fix the problem. As expected, the status display is back to normal, but the events are still visible. In this case, the operator must take action, because this is more than just a nuisance alarm. And that's how Event Auto-Acknowledge works. It's a niche function, mostly required for industrial networks. So you won't find it in many office network management systems. But if you have inconsequential intermittent faults in your network, you'll find that this function reduces the stress for your operators. And this will result in higher network availability. I hope you found this video interesting. Thank you for watching.